Aloha, this is Sky, your soulful progressive with FNN, Feminist News Network, that feminist news that's right for you. Welcome to Sky in the Studio, giving you that soulful news you need, yes indeed. And you haven't told a friend to like and subscribe and get that soulful news today, you better let them know it's on its way. You can see it today. I know that's right. Hit those links below that says Feminist News Network and you can see more videos. I know that's right. And don't forget to like and subscribe, like I said. Now, what do I want to talk to you about today? What is going on in the DNC, in the election cycle, in this before primary and the end of the debates? Who has dropped out? Cory Booker. They have told him to hit the road and he gotta go, because they said, hit the road, Booker, and don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Booker, and don't you come back no more. Now, this is what Booker said. What you say, DNC, don't treat me so mean. You're the meanest party I've ever seen. If I don't have the money and votes, I gotta pack my bags and go. That's right. All right. Now, that's what's going on with Booker. He doesn't have enough money to continue on with his electoral race. So he's out. The money is flat. No more supporters to donate. He chose not to go establishment, and maybe he tried to look for it on the side, but it was a little too little and a little too late. So he's out. Now that leaves the last known black candidate to be in the race with the DNC and the Democratic Party that be. Now there's still two more people of color, Andrew Yang and Tulsi Gabbard. Andrew Yang being Asian American and Tulsi Gabbard being part Samoan and Haole. And we're not going to get into the religions because I'm not going to do that. So with that being the only person, two people of color left, this makes it a very white bread interesting race. Now, what's going on, Warren? We don't want you to claim Indian now. It's too late. We already saw what's happened with that DNA. Now, I had to say that real quick. But what's going on is they're narrowing the field and they're getting to the person, the establishment, and the DNC and the super delegates are willing to put their support behind. Now, they don't talk about those super delegates. They don't even want to mention them this year because of what happened in Nevada last year. But people, we got to start bringing it up because it's real. The exit polls are real. Reacted Tonight talks about it. Jimmy mentions it every blue moon, but I'm talking about it every time. Keep up with what Greg Palast is doing right now and the Fair Vote campaign and fair.org and the things Stacey Abrams is doing also. Because these are your indicators, people, because Jimmy Carter has gotten too old to watch the votes to see. And we know that he told us in 2016 that this was a rigged election. Do we not remember that? This is a man that had seen elections in Ghana, seen over elections being held fairly in South America. And he knows a rigged election when he's seen one because he's been in one. Did I go there? You know I did. And if you agree with me, Because this is what I got to say about Cory Booker. He's still good for a VI pick. He's still good for a VP pick. And I know you agree with me on that. You know, he's still a fair, honest candidate. Now, apparently what he did with the charter schools and taking the money from Zuckerberg, not putting it into the public schools and other little schemes he did back in New Jersey that he shouldn't have did as mayor and take advantage of in regards to certain policing situations. He did not do the right thing. That's probably what cost him now. But he's still good enough for a VP pick if he takes the time to do right by his own city and redeem himself. But Cory, you need to run back and do that instead of chasing after this impeachment. That's just distraction, honey. Because Trump's going to keep the war going to keep that distraction. So if you work on your town, your state, and get something done within there, maybe it'll garner more votes out there and help you with your next election, where some people are going to think you ignored them for running for president just to find out you couldn't go all the way. And you agree with that? Leave comments below and let me know at feministnewsin@gmail.com. Don't forget to like and subscribe to the YouTube channel and the Facebook page. And remember that I'm That Soulful Progressive One on Twitter, and got that rant of the day on Blogger. And I'm That Soulful Progressive One on Twitter. Yeah. And got the Patreon. If you want a feminist news tea, just let me know indeed. And remember, I'm That One Woman Tea. That One Woman Tea. So if you care to donate, that's PayPal.me/Feminist News Network. Yes, indeed. So remember, in this era of hate, you gotta participate. Because if you don't, we won't have any more Cory Booker type of candidates. Is that a good or bad thing? Let me know. All right. So thanks for watching. Thanks for joining. Don't forget to vote and check your registration on your vote. Peace.